Good morning. Happy Friday, everyone. I want to talk for a while, actually, maybe like a series of videos about the characteristics of instinctive purpose. For those of you who don't know me, my company is Instinctive Life, and I take people through a six-step process that enables them to find their instinctive purpose, and then we work on helping them use that instinctive purpose in their life. So I thought it would be brilliant to go through what I think the characteristics of an instinctive purpose are. So if you're watching, you can kind of take what I'm talking about and apply it to your own life and kind of get an idea of what your instinctive purpose might be. And this all came up because of a conversation I was having with a friend. Those of you who have seen these blogs before know that that's typically where I get my material for these blogs. Anyway, I was having a conversation with a friend last night about characteristics of us that we tend to discount. And I really shouldn't say characteristics. I mean more skills, talents, abilities of ours that we tend to discount. So for example, if someone comes up to us and compliments us on something, we shrug our shoulders and say a variety of things like, oh, that's just me, or that's no big deal, everybody does that, or here's another one, I have so much fun doing it, it can't possibly be a skill, so we kind of shrug it off. And this is one of my favorite characteristics of instinctive purpose, because it's very telling. When you are naturally skilled at something, which is what I believe instinctive purpose comes from, it comes from what we are naturally skilled at doing. And so when we have a natural skill at doing something, we tend to discount it because it comes so easily to us. And so we assume a lot of things. First of all, that it's not valuable, because society tells us that for something to be valuable, you have to work really hard at it. You have to go to school. You have to get some kind of training. You have to work for years and years to hone your skill. Well, when you're naturally skilled at something, you've actually been working at it your entire life. And this is something that I can see in my own example of my instinctive purpose. My instinctive purpose is built up of a lot of things, as is yours. One of the things that it's built up with is my ability to listen. And this is exactly what my friend and I were talking about last night. My ability to listen to me is like, it's a no-brainer. I assume that everybody must do it. I absolutely love to do it. And so it just doesn't feel to me like something that is as valuable as if I went out and worked long and hard to try to gain this skill. But yet this skill of mine is something that I'm almost 40, so I've been working almost 40 years at this skill. I have been mastering and honing this skill, on top of which I was given this skill naturally at birth. That's what I believe. I believe we were all given a set of skills naturally at birth. And I've said this before, but the genius thing about this is that I actually want to do those things. The things I'm naturally skilled at, I want to do them, which is another characteristic of instinctive purpose that we'll get to later. So for those of you who are looking for your instinctive purpose, look to see what you are naturally skilled at. And the way that you can do that, one of the ways, is what are the things that when people compliment you, you tend to just kind of shrug your shoulders and discount it for a variety of reasons. Either you didn't go out and get training on it, so you don't see how it could possibly be valuable, or you do it so easily, it comes so naturally to you that you discount it because it's just always been a part of you, and it's always been normal and natural part of your existence. And then another thing is it comes so easily to you that you assume that everybody can do that. And that's what I've done with my listening ability. I've just assumed everybody can listen. And it's only been recently when I've learned from people that no, that's actually not the case. And not everybody can listen. Or can listen really, really well. So, gosh, it just makes me extraordinarily grateful that there's something that I love to do that I actually have natural skills at doing. So this is a really good way for you to start figuring out what your instinctive purpose is. When people come up to you and they compliment you on something, if you tend to shrug it off, if you tend to think that it's not worth much value, either because it's so fun to do or because it comes naturally to you, then that's a clue that that might be an element of your instinctive purpose. So what do you do with that? You take it and you try to use it and bring it into your life more. Okay, so I'm good at listening to people. What do I do with that? Well, I find a way to listen to people. Obviously, with my friends, that's easy. You know, it's easy to listen to them, and I love to listen to them. And fortunately, and this makes sense, my friends are people who love and are willing to share with me. They trust me, and you know, that might be part of it too. Maybe I help them trust me, but I think these people I'm just naturally drawn to because they're willing and open and honest and very, very giving and deep people. And so I love to listen to them. So I do that in my spare time, but then what do I do with my professional life? Well, for those of you who are in a job right now that you cannot see a way out of, you find a way to bring it into your job, your life, every aspect of your life. So for me, with listening, when I was working in my previous job, when I started to find these natural skills for me, I tried to bring them more into that job. But I was at a point where I was ready to bail. So I bailed, and I created something that used these things, that took these skills of mine and put them to use. And that's what you want to do. If you can't tweak your job and you're ready to leave and do something else, great, go do something else. Man, do I encourage that. But if you, and when you do though, gosh, take advantage of the risk that you take. Don't jump from the frying pan into the fire. Make sure that you are structuring and creating something around your skills, your interests, your desires, your passions. Doesn't that make sense? If you're going to take this huge leap of faith into a whole new world for you professionally, then take the time, spend the money, find the resources to create something that fits you. Don't just willy-nilly it. That's really, really important, I think. But if you are not able to leave your job for whatever reason, then do what you can to take those skills and bring them into your job more. Talk to your manager, talk to your boss, talk to the owner, talk to whomever you can talk to that might have some pull on how your job is structured. And even maybe say, look, I've been doing some self-study and some self-research, and frankly, good management really, really appreciates that. Now, that doesn't mean that all management out there is good, but good management really will appreciate some self-study if you've done it. You can go to them and say, look, this is what I've done. This is what I've discovered. I've discovered that I'm really naturally skilled in these areas. Can I prove myself? Ask them if you can prove yourself by taking on some tasks that will allow you to express those skills. And then just have a ball. Have a blast doing it, and you will be amazed what that feels like to start spending your days as much as possible expressing these natural skills that come, well, these skills, let me say that differently, these skills that come so naturally to you. It will feel so good. I often talk about it being like a fish out of water when you're not using the skills that you're naturally inclined to use and naturally structured to use. It feels like you're a fish out of water, like you're trying to breathe air when you should be breathing water. So get back in the water and feel what that feels like. It'll be such a relief, and it won't be so labored. Your life will not be so labored. So try that out. See if it works. And man, I would love to hear your stories. Email me, Tammy, T-A-M-M-I, at instinctivelife.com. Or you can find me on the website, www.instinctivelife.com. So let me know how that works for you. I totally want to compile stories and put them out there for people to see. So share your stories with me. Let me know how it goes. Have a great Friday, a great weekend, and I will see you on Monday.